the square. Backdoor cut. Martin with a... Bam! Bam! Chill! Bam! Hey! Hey, yo, what's good? Welcome back to Coach DT Reacts. So, we got the NBA Finals happening this week, all right? We got the Denver Nuggets and the Miami Heat. Yes, sir, locked in the Game 3 action. All right, coming at you, not live, a little bit after live, just a little bit after live tonight, all right? Real quick, though, all right? If you caught my Game 2 reaction, then you obviously know I kind of saw this coming, to be honest, right? Let's check it out. All right, so we got Bam bringing it up. Oh, right quick and roll action. Oh my goodness, Bam with that reverse right there. That's tough. That's a nice little reverse to left hand. All right, K-Love. Wow, yes, sir. Look at that volume down a little bit. K-Love came out, splash. His first three looked good right there. But I knew this bad actor right here, Jamal Murray, was going to come in with an aggressive mentality, and that he did. Jimmy was heavy. I love that heavy by Jimmy right there. That was tough. All right, Yoke with Jimmy on the block. Jimmy on the block. Not Jimmy, but Jimmy. And Jimmy on the block got put in the cup. All right, little pick and roll action. Bam. Oh, kick the corner. Vincent, splash. Nice shot by Gabe Vincent. Miami came out with the energy that they should have on their home court. You love to see it. Little pick and roll action right there. How'd that ball find Porter? I think Porter got fouled right there, but they didn't get any love. All right. Yoke right there. Yes, sir. Yoke with that little mini action is kind of tough, too. Him and Bam are both very proficient at mini action. Oof. Once again, look at the hook he's tossing. That's beautiful. 2016 right here. Jamal Murray bothering Jimmy. But Jimmy's really... I was telling my love the other day... To be honest, it feels like Jimmy just has these guys on this team that he knows that he can score on, and he just goes right at them. You see young Bron right there getting put in the mini action right there. Nice angle found right there on the glass by Mr. Green, Uncle Jeff Green. That's a tough shot by Kyle Lowry to finish the first quarter. Finish the first quarter, tied 24-24. That did not last long. Splash there. Splash there. Immediately 29-25. Denver. Duncan Robinson swinging it. Pump fake. Oh, Euro. Dump off. Dunk in. Yes, sir. Nice look right there by Martin. Martin dumps it right to Bam. Bam puts that thing right where it belongs. 29-29 here. Oh, good find right. Christian Brown is tough. Did you see the bounce right there? I thought you saw that, right? Huh. Let me just dump that thing in immediately. Bam couldn't get off the ground quick enough. That's tough. Alright. Duncan Robinson making stuff happen off the dribble. You don't really see Duncan Robinson doing a lot of off the dribble work. Oh, yeah, Lowry creating turnovers. Martin in transition. Oh, my. That's acrobatic. That's the only word I can think of for that. Acrobatic. All right. Yoke. Oh. Oof. Tough shot. That's a tough shot right there by Jamal Murray, man. It's a tough step back three, especially moving to your right. If you're a hooper, you know. If you're moving towards your strong hand, all right, it's tougher to get your shoulders square. You really got to put the effort into getting square. Backdoor cut. Martin with a... Bam! Bam! Chill! Bam! Hey! Get out of the way, Yoke! All right, Yoke backing him down. Finds Murray again. Splash, man. Nah, I gotta go back, man. I gotta see Bam do that thing again, man. That was nasty. Hold on. Hey, yes, sir. Yoke stumbling, bumbling, tumbling out the picture. That's a big boy dunk. Yes, sir. 44-42 Miami.
Yoke backing him down. Finds Murray. Rises.
Man, he shines, man. Like I said, Murray really has the efficiency of a top 10 scorer, man. I mean, it's really tough. 49-46, Denver. Hey! Yes, sir. Gordon just right down the freaking runway, man. You love to see it. 53-48. Halftime just came and went. Yoke's gonna pull that midi and slash that midi. 57-48, excuse me. A little separation right here. If I'm Miami, I'm a little nervous about the beginning of this fourth quarter. Especially with dime being dropped like that. You see the dime droppage right here? Watch the dime right there. Beautiful dime. If you missed it, it was right there. Gorgeous dime. 61-52. Come on, Miami. You need to push. Little pick and roll action. Bam, hit that midi. Bam. Kind of cooled off on his mini work. I was really impressed with his mini work in game two. His mini work did not show itself as efficiently in game three. Yoke, his mini work did show itself. Yoke mini work seemed like it's pretty consistent. 70-57 is a 13-point ball game. Jimmy for three. Last, he squeezed that one in there. 70-60. Yo, right back at him. Bow. Yes, sir. Let me get that back, he said. He said, let me get that back. 74-60. Where did that free throw come from? That's strange. All right. Oh, good pass right there by Kyle Lowry. Finds Jimmy in the baseline cut. Uh-huh. And that's the issue. Is that a whistle? That's the issue with the size of Miami. Denver, man. This is a 17-point separated ball game. Oh, and Christian Brown is. Whoa. Christian Brown. That was hot, bro. For real, huh? Give me that. All right, get off me. Excuse me, you're a baby. Hey! Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Make him learn how to say your last name, Brody. Pump fake, kick the corner. Robinson for three. You squeeze that thing in there. 7, 6, 5, 4. Come on, Jimmy, 3, 2, 1. Good tough move. Good tough move. To bring the lead to 16. All right, 14 here. Make it 16 again. 16 again. 88-70. It's an 18-point ball game. Miami's got to make a run early in the fourth. If they don't, they don't have a shot. 88-72. Kyle Lowry did not show up. He only took 5 shots. He has 4 points. Christian Brown is just too tough, too strong. Alright, he said, get you some of this right here, bro. He said, get you some of that. Alright, Christian Brown again in transition. Excuse me, get bump and one. Jimmy, get your weight up, he said. He said, Jimmy, get your weight up, bro. He said, don't think I'm a mismatch. You a mismatch, Jimmy. Talk to him, Christian. Uh-huh. Lowry rising for three. It's about time you pull a shot, bro. Come, can you play ball? Christian Brown is busting your neck. Oh, my gosh. Turnover. All right. Kicking ahead. Martin. Tough lay. And one, in my opinion. Give me my bump. 93-79. Y'all got to D up. Good defense. Gabe Vincent working down there. With Gordon. But my man, Jamal is just tough. Jamal! Pump fake, excuse me, spin move, excuse me, bump and one. I'm tougher than you. That's really MVP work. Alright, they gave it to Embiid, but that's he's really out here putting his MVP work in. Y'all see my face. Y'all see my face. Y'all see my face. There's no way he meant that nice soft touch, that high off the glass with the English. Please. Come on, man. That's too much. It's too much. All right, pump fake. Let's get pull. Duncan Robinson for three. Nice right there. 101-90. Excuse me, 103-91. Duncan Robinson rising, taking a tough three. Oh, my gosh. Duncan, I need you shooting in the first quarter if I'm Miami. Oh, my goodness, boy. 109-94, going to beat the final for game 3 of the NBA Finals, man. Denver comes right in, says, let me get that home court back. Let me get that home court back real quick. Like, which, like I said, Coach Malone and company was going to have them boys right. Shout out to CCBN for pumping these amazing highlights out extremely quickly. We appreciate your consistent work. You do a great job. Head over there, light that stuff up, share that stuff up, show them some love. Winners go first, man. Denver Nuggets. All right, Aaron Gordon, 34 minutes, 5 of 10 from the field, right? 1 of 4 from the free throw line. You don't really love that, especially whenever you're going to expect him to get his 5 of 10 in the next game, right? So if I am Miami, I consider fouling him more often with that 7, that 1 of 4 right there. That might be a strategy you consider. 10 rebounds. It's very active, though. You love that. You love his plus 16. Is he leading starters in plus minus? Yes, he is. Plus 16 right there. 11 points. You'll take that. Michael Porter Jr. This is 2 games in a row. This is kind of scary if you're Denver. There's 2 games in a row where MPJ has been just, I want to say bottled up, because I don't think you can bottle up a guy that's 6'10". I feel like it's a head thing. Is the moment just kind of, and if you look at KCP right there, 1 of 4 as well. Once again, is the moment just kind of getting a little too big? Well, my dad say, don't you choke on me. All right. Rest in peace, Coach Gould would say. All right. These guys, that 107, 104 is glaring. Let's see if they bounce back in game. Because, I mean, honestly, if you're Miami, you're licking your chops with that, really. You're not expecting Jamal Murray and Nikola Jokic to both do another 30-point triple-double, are you? By the way. Can we talk about that? Wow. 30-point triple-double. All right, we're talking 34 points. All right, for Jamal Murray. We're talking 10 boards, 10 assists. All right, 12 of 22 from the field, 3 of 6 from the three. Big threes. I saw several big threes from Jamal Murray. 7 of 8 from the free throw line as well. Nikola, jump up there. And by the way, the 45 minutes, mwah. All right, extra minutes from Coach Malone. And them boys said, yes, sir, let me eat that up. Nikola, all right, 12 of 21, solid. All right, that's efficiency work. All right, 1 of 2 from the 3, you love it. All right, 7 of 8 from the free throw line, just like his partner in crime. Look at these boards. 21 boards. All right, 18 defensive. All right, that's incredible board work. Board man gets paid according to that guy that go, hey. All right, Kawhi Leonard. All right, 10 assists. He's going to drop 10 dimes as well as the 21 boards. Man, come on, man. Plus 15 in the boxy box. 32 points in his 44 minutes. That is MVP work, like I said. But he has an MVP-type partner in crime, if you ask me. I'm going to start calling Jamal Murray. It's audacious, but he got that efficiency of a Wardell, if you know what I mean, right? That's impressive. If he can continue to score at that clip, man, he's going to have a really, really bright career. So glad he's back and healthy. The bench work, there was none. I see 5 points from Brown. I see 4 from Green. Christian Brown down there, 15 points off the bench. Actually, and that's disrespectful because I definitely saw Christian Brown putting that work in. I said there was no bench work. There was not really any bench work except for the Brown brothers, all right? Braun and Brown, right? Christian Brown, incredible work, all right? Taking advantage of your athleticism, your young legs. You're like the quickest guy out there, to be honest, which tells me you probably didn't play as many minutes throughout the season. You have some fresh legs going on right now, and your youth is taking advantage of some of the, what do you call it, banged-up Miami Heat players, right? And so, solid stuff. And of course, Bruce Brown did an incredible job himself coming off the bench and taking care of business as well. 1 of 5, 1 of 3, and 2 of 2 aren't something to write home mom about, but you're playing good defense because you're plus 8. Or you are in the action in the right spots and making the right passes in your 29 minutes. So you love to see it. Now, the Heatles! All right, Miami Heat. K-Love started off hot. I hit his first 3. Did not do much else, man. Minus 10, 6 points. Not a great night. Jimmy Buckets shot 24 shots. Only dropped 11 buckets. Not extremely efficient. However, you did get the free throw line. You were aggressive. 5 of 6 from the free throw line you will take. But you were minus 11 in the boxy box, right? 28 points. Nothing wrong with that.
Bam, 7-21. Like I said, his midi work wasn't as efficient. You really need Bam to hit that midi at like a 50% clip. If you can get Bam to hit that midi at a 50% clip, plus get to the free throw line for his 8 of 10, you have a much better shot. Right, I think this game was an 11-point game. And so, to me, it's really manageable if you get some more from Gabe Vincent. Right, Gabe Vincent and Max Strus, right, did not shoot the way they shot in game 2, which you can't expect them to consistently shoot 50% from the three, but man, dropping way back down to 1 of 7 and 2 of 10 hurts your team. Hurts your team big time. So they got to be more consistent. All right, like I said, they're underrated, but that inconsistently came to really bite them in this particular game. Game 3 was a big one. I think that's the pretty favorable statistics for the game 3 winner in these final series. Udonis Haslem got in and got some, I say he got minutes. He got 1 field goal up, but 0 minutes. That's impressive. That man pulled it from the bench. No, he did get in. I think he had 28 seconds. So shout out to Udonis Haslem for becoming the oldest player to ever play in the NBA Finals. That's actually incredible and a really, really wonderful stat if you really think about it. Duncan Robinson came off the bench, only had 9 points, right? 3 of 6 from the field, 3 of 6 from three. Impressive. I need Duncan Robinson taking more shots, to be honest. If he's going to shoot 50% from the three, you really want him to be pulling more threes, in my opinion. He was a -4. He's got a guard. He's got a guard. Martin came off 32 minutes. A lot of minutes for him. 10 points. He was a -5. Zeller was a +4, which is impressive because Jokic seems to think he can bully Zeller, and he usually does a pretty good job of bullying Zeller. Kyle Lowry did not have a great showing. 1 of 4 from the three-point line is not what you really want to see. 4 of 8 from the field, you'll take. But Kyle Lowry, I feel like you got to be more aggressive and get to the line more, right? I feel like pulling threes is not really going to benefit you guys too much. You got to get in the lane. Although, I say this, the length that the Denver Nuggets provides is very, very tough to deal with. So, that being said, before this thing gets too lengthy, if you made it to this point in the video, we appreciate the love. Please like, share, and subscribe to Coach DT. All right, it helps me with the algorithm. It does a wonderful job of just spreading the, well, what do you call it, gospel of Coach DT's basketball breakdowns. And we really appreciate the love and support of each and every one of you that take the time to share. We know that you doing your time, spending your time doing anything in the world, and you're spending it here with Coach DT. So we appreciate that. That being said, all right, peace. Vote that outro.